All right, just got here and we're going to be doing this furnace tune-up on this furnace. This thing was put in back in 2010, so we're 13 years old. Let's see what's going on here. As you can see, it's a little dirty. It's a little dusty down here. I'm going to pull the blower and or at least look inside and see if that needs to be taken out and cleaned. Looks like we got had some drainage issues there, but we're going to go perform a tune-up. First thing I like to do is, before I fire everything up, is test the igniter, make sure the ohms are within range. This is the older style igniter, so it just got done running not too long ago, so it's going to be up there in temperature or ohm reading. It's probably going to be right around 80. Anything over 100, it's shot on these. And if anything over 100, it needs to be replaced. Obviously, you set your meter to ohms, and we're at 87.5. So the igniter's still good. Like I said, if it reaches, if it's right around 100 ohms or more, it's shot. It needs to be replaced. So that igniter's good. Another thing I like to do before I start everything up is check the capacitance on the motor capacitor. So you check, just send your meter over to MFD, microfarads. This is a 10 UF. Well, we're actually good. We're 10.12. So we're good on that. And you can see, maybe, it's plus minus 6. So we're within specs on that one. And another thing I like to do is record my measurements. This gets sent to, I use CompanyCam, and this gets sent to my file through CompanyCam for my client. And that way I got readings, notes, all that stuff. Then you can add a description. And you save it. So same thing, I like to take my readings from my igniter. Then I can add a note. Save. And that goes right to my notes on my, right on my dashboard of my company cam, which gets linked up to my house call pro. All right, getting ready to test microamps on the flame sensor back there. Check gas pressures. This here's your adjustment screw underneath here. This is where you check the pressures at. This is what I do. You unscrew that just a little bit. Right there. Let's see, where is my... Then you stick this tube on. It's got this little fitting. Just like that. And set you back up here. Zero it out. Oh, that's a good that's where I like it at. Obviously, this is really important. Got to make sure, obviously the gas is off. Got to make sure you tighten that back up. That's really important. You don't know how many times I've been busy throughout the day, go do a job, lay there at 3 o'clock in the morning. Did I tighten that back up? Because if you don't tighten that back up, you can imagine what will happen. Boom. Thank you. I'm gonna put the door back on so that way it's burning like a normal state. Yeah, the CO is starting to drop. O2's dropping a little bit. Until this thing reaches a steady state. Yeah, we're within specs. That's good. This thing's burning really efficient. Then you can scan this. This is in the back rack app. Let me see if I can find it. Combustion back rack. So basically, you can set all those up in there. Hit QR code scan. Then it prints everything out on my phone. Then I can actually save that to my file in my company cam directory. It's got all the everything that I need in there. This is pretty slick, you know. This is the insight. And I actually saved this. I 2 weeks ago dropped this into a bucket of water at a customer's house, and I was freaking out because I thought it was ruined. But I went home and took the batteries out, stuck it in a box of rice, and I saved it, and it still works. So I'm very blessed with that. Because these things aren't cheap. These things are almost $2,000. You know, but yeah, there's that. So what I'll do, I'll screenshot this. And I also can send this as a PDF. Save it. PDF file. Share. So I'll save the files. Save. Then I can actually go here. Edit this. Done. And then I can take it over to my company cam app. Add documents. Click that. document processing, and then I'll have this on my CompanyCam app. Easy peasy. That's the thing I like to do is test my amps on my motor. So we're actually 3.13 locked rotor. So we're within specs of that. Obviously with the Field Piece app, you can use it right on your phone. Sorry, that was full lock rotor, which is 2.63, and it's 2.4, so we're within specs in there. This is your total amp. This is with everything running. Just under 7.5 amps with that running in the blower. What's really nice with this Field Piece meter, this SC680, you can just stick it in the blower compartment and you can shut the door so that way it's where it should be as far as the amp draw goes on your, because obviously when you got your blower, your door open, and you got your door open, you don't get the proper readings. So this will tell me what my amps are when that blower comes on. So it starts up high, then it ramps back down. And I take a screenshot of this. And I'll put that on my records. Once again, I go to my add documents, blower amps, and it will be right there. There's my blower amps. Right in the CompanyCam. Right here is total current 20 amps, so we're way below where we need to be on that. And another thing I like to do is take out the blower and check the how dirty it is, and then check that secondary heat exchanger as well. take you in a little closer here. It's actually not that bad. It's a little dirty, not bad. I'll run the vacuum on it. Vacuum in here. Blower's got a little bit of dust on it, but not bad at all. Or I should say the blower wheel. It's not hospital clean, but it's clean for what it is. Guess if I had my nitrogen with me, I could probably blow everything out, but I don't. Take a wipe and just kind of wipe things down. Wet towel, whatever. This back. And these York Luxairs, gotta take, always like loosening. Brackets right here, just a little bit. That way you can slide that blower in a little bit easier. Otherwise it's a real pain. Thank you. much easier. And you just plug things back in where they go. New trellis. New trellis. That's transformer. And that's your L1. And this is all the other doodads. Just like brand new. All right, let me vacuum the rest of it. All right, another thing I like to do is check for gas leaks. I'm using the Klein Tools ET120, and I'm getting some bleed through on this gas valve. And it's I got it on the high setting. So this gas valve is starting to become no bueno, no good, because it's bleeding through. It's not closing all the way. So I'm getting a little bit of gas smell coming out of the orifice right there. I kept smelling a little bit of whiff of gas. That's why I did what I did here. So I'm going to talk to the client and get this gas valve replaced. Gas is off. same thing. One of my really old customers, God, that's probably been 20 years ago, 25 years old, gave me this pipe wrench. He was in his 80s when he gave me that, but he used to be a pipe fitter. This is one of the best pipe wrenches that I've ever used. It's great. It's an old rigid, heavy duty. Is better. Can we fire this up with this new valve on, checking gas pressures? Just a titch high. Like the old one. Nice and tight. All right, got everything taken care of. Gas leak fixed on the water heater. Furnace is all dialed in, ready to go. Thanks for watching.